My aspiration in life would be to be happy.
First and foremost, I would like to wish each and every one of you a happy New Year's Day. We have embarked upon page one of page 365. I hope each and every one of you take the just stand to write your own story and keep that pen in your possession. So yesterday was day two of my visits with the clinical psychologist or whatever you want to call her. But it was a great visit. I've learned a lot about myself since I have been going. Yesterday, I learned that I have a fear of abandonment. I also learned that as it relates to relationships, I walk around like this. I walk around like this. Basically pushing people, not necessarily out of my life, but keeping people away from me. Keeping people at a distance. I also learned that I have a tendency to stare into the rearview mirror, not focusing on what's in front of me. So, someone who has a fear of abandonment have dealt with something traumatic that made them feel as if they were abandoned. Generally speaking, whenever a child deals with a father who was not in his life or a mother who wasn't in her life, that child grows up without that mother or father bond. That's a form of abandonment. And as you progress in age, that abandonment sticks with you. So you're always, like in many situations, especially in relationships, and sometimes in friendships, you have this fear, a fear that you just cannot seem to break. A fear that someone's going to leave you. It's a fear of abandonment. But I'm here to tell you that don't let this fear of abandonment get the best of you in relationships and friendships. Because people are going to leave you. People are going to leave you. Sometimes it's meant to be. You just have to deal with it as it comes. People are meant to be in your life for a reason, a season, or a lifetime. If somebody is meant to be in your life, then they will remain in your life. Don't sit around and worry yourself sick. Don't sit around and become so anxious and stressed out of fear that somebody's going to leave you. Because guess what? Somebody is going to leave you. So what? At the end of the day, you still have you. And don't find yourself in situations to where you're doing everything. You're exerting so much energy and time trying to keep somebody in your life. No matter how much money you spend, no matter how much you tell someone you love them, no matter how much you tell someone you like them, no matter how many gifts you buy, no matter how many times you take them to the movies, or no matter how many times you take them to dinner, at the end of the day, if that person wants to leave, no matter what you do, they're going to leave. And again, it's okay. Situations in your life. Some heartbreaking situations that have led you to have trust issues. These things happen to the best of us. But it's important that no matter how detrimental you feel like this situation was in your life, it's important for you to understand, yes, I went through this heartbreak. Take a lesson from the heartbreak. What can I do moving forward to prevent this from happening? What can I do moving forward to prevent a reoccurrence? Okay? And once you have taken away the lesson from that heartbreak, it's time to drop your arms. Especially when you're going into new relationships. If you walk into a new relationship with your arm extended, basically keeping that person at a distance, You're never going to get anywhere. You're never going to get anywhere. Sometimes it's important for us to allow some vulnerability. Because if we don't, again, we're stagnant in this position. And the person that we like, the person that likes us, the person that's trying to get into us, they can't because we have them at a distance. And it's especially challenged if you're placed in the position to where the individual that you like and the individual that like you, both of you guys have your arms extended. So again, you're pushing each other away. Why? Because you both have your arms extended. Sometimes it's important for you to drop those arms. Yes, you might have dealt with heartbreak in 2012. Yes, he might have lied to you for 5 years. You lived. Things happen. But what you have to realize is whenever you're getting into new relationships, it's time to drop your arms. It's time to go into this new relationship with a clean slate. However, it's important that you monitor who you give your trust to. Only give your trust to individuals who are worthy of having your trust. Do not go out giving your trust out like candy on Halloween night. Don't do that. Once you feel like you have met someone who is worthy of your trust and you have made up in your mind that for whatever reason, this individual I feel like is worthy of my trust, at that point, it's time to drop your arms. Let someone in. Let someone in. Let someone do the things that Jim, Joe, and John didn't do. Let someone in to do the things that Jane, Jill, or Jennifer didn't do. Drop your arms when it's necessary. You cannot go into new relationships with the expectancy that he or she is going to do the same thing that your ex did. Because that new relationship that you're embarking upon, it's not going to last. So I know I've spoken on things that have happened to you in the past, heartaches, heartbreaks, mix-up, mismatches, whatever. And looking at those situations and finding the lesson in each one of those situations that have happened to you. Now, what I want to say is, it's okay. Remember, I've spoken on that rearview mirror. It's okay to look in that rearview mirror and see where you have came from. But when you find yourself in the situation to where you began to stare in that rearview mirror, what you have to realize is you're driving, right? You're pressing forward in life. You're moving on, okay? While you're staring in that mirror, an accident is going to happen. You're going to crash. Because you're staring into what has happened to you, what you have gone through. It's important that you take your focus out of that rearview mirror and redirect it to your windshield. Focus on what's going on in your life right now. Focus on the now. Again, it's perfectly okay for you to glance in the rearview mirror and see where you have come from. It's important that you not forget where you've came from. It's okay for you to go back, for you to look in that rearview mirror just to see the lesson that you learned in that heartbreak whenever John cheated on you or whenever Jill left you. It's okay. But do not stare in that rearview mirror too long. Your focus should be the windshield.
My aspiration in life would be to be happy.
What you wear is all that matters. head.